Hello and welcome to this first module on urban diagnostics. In other words, on the assessment of the initial situation. If you want to serve a whole city with the right blend of sanitation systems and services, you need to understand the city first. You want to get a common vision with all the key stakeholders, and for that reason, collecting information should be used to get them engaged in the process. Several tools exist to help you do such an assessment, work with stakeholders, and render the results in a visual way. In this module, we will talk about the goals of the assessment of the initial situation, introduce a number of assessment tools, and see how to assess the enabling environment from different angles. Data collection itself will be presented in the next module. The assessment of the initial situation is a crucial step when planning for citywide inclusive sanitation. Don't forget to allocate sufficient time, budget, and human resources for it. If done well, it will allow you to save a lot of money and time later on. The main goals of the assessment of the initial situation are to set the scene, understand the existing sanitation systems and services, understand the institutional and regulatory framework, identify and get to know the stakeholders, compile and structure information, and last but not least, to fill data gaps. All in all, it is about collecting evidence to be able to make informed decisions. In this course, we will talk a lot about evidence-based decision-making. But what is evidence? Evidence is about collecting good quality, reliable data. Best to collect your own first-hand data. Second-hand data, meaning data from existing reports or official statistics, for example, can also provide evidence, but second-hand data should always be questioned. You should ask yourself who collected this data, when, and with which methods. There is a lot of bad or outdated data around. Another important point you have to mind is the representativeness of your data. Does it encompass the whole city and its whole diversity? Does it represent all its inhabitants with all the diversity in income, gender, culture? Do you also have the relevant information about the most vulnerable people and neighborhoods? Let's now look at a few tools that will help you structure your data collection and translate your data into useful visual outputs. At the pre-concept stage, there is a tool that has already been very briefly mentioned to you, the fecal waste flow diagram, or sheet flow diagram, or in short, SFD. The SFD fosters a certain data collection plan, which helps you to understand where human excreta goes, what is treated or not, what sanitation systems in your city is relying on. Please note that data should be collected and discussed with the key sanitation stakeholders in order to get buy-in at an early stage. The SFD tool turns the data collected into an automatically generated flow diagram. Go to the SFD website to learn more and make your own SFD, and watch the dedicated module in this course. Think, for example, about the impact for the public of this fecal sludge discharged directly into the sea of this large coastal city. If SFD is a powerful advocacy tool, it is because many decision makers don't actually realize the sanitation gap in their city and its consequences. An SFD is a great way to engage the key stakeholders in your project. Let's now move to the scoping and data collection itself. Different tools exist to understand from different angles what is the physical scope of the problems. The Urban Sanitation Status Index tool helps to map out information. An example will be shown in the next module. The QNQ method seeks to collect the data relevant to determine the quantities and qualities of fecal sludge, which is the basis for the design of fecal sludge treatment plants. It will be explained in details in a dedicated module. Finally, we encourage you to try out the assessment tools provided in the FSM toolbox, especially FSM Pro Assessment, which allows you to make geo-reference surveys and helps you analyze and visualize your data. let's now move to the enabling environment part. So to the question, why is a situation like this? There, we need to look at the situation from different angles. There is no tool that can do all of that, but you can use methods to help you address each angle more systematically. The City Service Delivery Assessment, or CSDA, is the most exhaustive tool to address the different dimensions of the enabling environment. Such a tool helps to collect data in a systematic way, while engaging stakeholders. It will be presented in detail in a dedicated module, but I can already deliver a key message here. The process is as important as a result. If you want to understand the stakeholders in order to develop a stakeholder engagement strategy, you can do a stakeholder analysis. If you need to understand the formal and informal rules of the sector, you can search for examples of institutional analysis and political economy analysis. I'll learn more in the module Working Politically. It will help you assess the influence and interest of stakeholders, their needs and constraints, the informal and formal relationship between them, and to make a so-called stakeholder mapping. It will also help you understand which incentives and barriers exist for the proper functioning of sanitation in your city. We will tell you more in the module on stakeholder analysis and engagement. If you want to introduce new practices at household level, some method will help you to assess the behaviors and preferences of people. Please refer to the module on behavior change. The list presented in this module is not exhaustive and is aimed to help you understand which types of tools or families of tools exist. If you find other good tools or have feedback on the tools and approaches presented, don't hesitate to share. In all cases, please make sure that you consider the many dimensions of urban sanitation service provision. Everything is interrelated, and all the assessment tools should be seen as different ways to contribute to one single assessment and not distinct studies. Use different data collection methods and different data sources. You will learn more about it in the next module. And don't do it alone on your desk. It is important first interaction with the sanitation stakeholders and contributes to trust building for the whole process. Make sure that you plan enough time, budget, and human resources when you bid. It is clear that you will have to find a trade-off between exhaustive data and basic information collection. Remember that a good urban diagnostic is about the quality of the data and its analysis. Focus on good visuals and avoid data symmetries, these long reports and Excel sheets which are unreadable. In the next module, we will focus on data collection. See you then!